When asked about his stand on the International Criminal Court's probe into drug war killings in the Philippines, Foreign Affairs Secretary Manalo said the ICC should just stick to its mandate. He said the problem with the ICC is that it sometimes tries to get into issues in countries that have working judicial systems. The ICC has suspended its probe into the Duterte administration's deadly anti-narcotics campaign as it awaits a comment from the Philippine government. ICC prosecutor Karim Khan earlier said the Philippines has not demonstrated that it is sufficiently investigating these killings. The Philippines is willing to resume talks with China on a possible joint oil and gas exploration in the West Philippine Sea. This was bared by Foreign Affairs Secretary Enrique Manalo to lawmakers during his confirmation hearing Wednesday. The talks between Manila and Beijing were previously terminated by the Duterte administration, citing constitutional constraints and issues on sovereignty. Manalo says he has discussed the possibility of reviving negotiations with his Chinese counterpart.
Philippines is open because we will to talks on oil and gas because we think we need to see how we can develop those resources, which gas and oil, which especially nowadays are in sore need. And certainly the Philippines will need it not only for now, but for the long term.
Meanwhile, Senator Aimee Marcos confronted Manalo over a supposedly weak stance on the Sabah issue involving the heirs of the Sulu Sultanate and the Malaysian government. Senator Marcos cited a newspaper column calling out Manalo for his alleged silence on the French court ruling ordering Malaysia to pay nearly $15 billion to the heirs of the Sulu Sultanate for breach of an international private lease agreement.
On the article which was mentioned, of course, that is an issue which, first of all, actually I was never asked about it. We have discussed it, and the Department of Foreign Affairs is coordinating with other agencies to really assess the nature of the and the implications of the issue. And I'm in touch with them, and our feeling is that this is an issue which involves legal, political aspects, so it's important the other agencies or departments in the government also give us their views. So when we, if issue a statement, we're pretty clear what the implications will be. And this is under active consideration.
The International Atomic Energy Agency, or IAEA, wants to establish a permanent residence at the Russian-held nuclear plant in Ukraine. That's according to its chief, Rafael Grossi, who is leading a 14-man team to inspect the Zaporizhzhia nuclear power plant. Grossi says their mission is to prevent a nuclear accident amid fighting between Moscow and Kyiv at the site. The team is expected to visit the plant on Thursday.
Well, the mission will take a few days, and if we are able to establish a permanent presence, or a continued presence, better said, then it's going to be prolonged.
But
this first segment, so to speak, is going to take a few days.
Meanwhile, the U.S. Justice Department claims to have uncovered efforts to obstruct its probe into former President Donald Trump's alleged mishandling of classified documents. Prosecutors told a court Tuesday Trump's lawyers falsely declared in June that all White House records in his possession were stored in Mar-a-Lago storage room. FBI agents earlier this month found classified documents even in Trump's office. The Justice Department claims they were likely concealed to obstruct an FBI probe into Trump's potential mishandling of classified materials. The court filing was a response to Trump's request for a so-called special master or an independent party to review the seized documents. Government has reportedly recovered over 300 classified materials from Mar-a-Lago since Trump left office. China may have committed crimes against humanity in Xinjiang region. That's according to the long-awaited report of outgoing United Nations Human Rights Chief Michelle Bachelet. According to that report, patterns of torture allegations against Uyghurs and other Muslims in Xinjiang were credible. It adds the right situation there requires urgent international attention. Bachelet released the report just minutes before her four-year term ended Wednesday. China is accused of detaining more than 1 million Uyghurs and other Muslim minorities in the region. But it denies the accusations, calling the network of prisons and camps in Xinjiang training centers. last month, Reuters obtained a copy of a letter from China asking Bachelet to bury the report.